Here we want to determine from the density of iron oxide what is the length of the unit cell. So I've drawn the unit cell. Iron oxide has the rock salt structure, and there's another screencast that describes the rock salt structure. The corner atoms of this cube and on the faces are oxygens. The smaller iron atoms are located on the faces and in the center in octahedral sites, and the stoichiometry is 1:1. The density is going to be the mass for this unit cell over the volume. What we're trying to determine is this distance that we're going to call A. So the density we know is 5.70 grams per cubic centimeter. The mass, there's four oxygen atoms, each has 16 grams per mole in the unit cell, and I determine this number from there are eight oxygen atoms on the corners. Each of them are shared with seven others, so there's 8 × 1/8. And then there's six oxygen atoms on the faces, and they're each shared with another unit cell, so that's 6 × 1/2, so this corresponds to 4 oxygen atoms in the cell, which means there must be 4 iron. And so if we look up the atomic mass for iron, 55.8 grams per mole. And the volume is just going to be A cubed. And this is going to be equal to 5.70 grams per centimeter cubed. However, this is 1 cube. I've looked at grams per mole, so I need Avogadro's number here in order to account for an entire mole. And so if we now multiply out this equation, let's solve for A cubed. 287.4 grams per mole divided by 5.70 grams per centimeter cubed and multiply by 6.023 × 10²³ per mole, so that units are going to be consistent. A cubed is 8.37 × 10²³ centimeters cubed, which means A is 4.37 × 10⁻⁸ centimeters. And let's convert it to the units we're more likely to use with unit cells. Let's convert it to nanometers. There's 10⁹ nanometers per meter, and there's 10² centimeters per meter. So the units here are going to cancel and give us 0.437 nanometers. And so this is the length of the unit cell for iron oxide.